Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. Thank you for coming back. So what I'm going to be figuring out now is how to put in the electronics. So first of all, here is the instrument panel. It's not a real one, right? It's just a piece of paper. And I've already prepared this forward frame and also the next one down, which is this one. I've adapted it. I don't know if it's visible. No, it isn't. To make space for the servo arm, for the ailerons. Now I have to figure out how to connect both engines, and the engines are going to be sitting somewhere here. There's one here and one here. So that's one engine. And here's the other engine, right? These are brushed motors, so they're not as powerful, but the good thing of that is that they can in theory be connected to one single ESC. And this is the ESC. I want to put the ESC at this height, at this level of the fuselage, and then I want to squeeze the battery in here. Now I'm a little bit worried from the perspective of center of gravity, because it's supposed to be somewhere at this level is the center of gravity, but this was designed to have internal combustion engines, which I'm sure they're heavier than these motors. So I'm a little bit worried about that center of gravity not being forward enough, or the weight not being forward enough. So for sure I want to make sure I keep the battery here in the front, ahead of that center of gravity, and the ESC also ahead of that center of gravity. If possible, also the servo, though the servo is also just a couple of grams, and it'll be somewhere on the center of gravity line. So as you can see, maybe you can't, but as I see already, the cables that come out of the motors are not long enough to connect then to the ESC. The connectors to the ESC are somewhere at this height. And I believe, and I still have to figure it out, if it's going to be a parallel or a series connection. I think it's parallel, but I have to figure it out. So I'm going to have to extend these cables of the motors, connect them, and then connect those extenders into the ESC. The ESC has two servers, micro servers included. And these are the ones that then control back there. They're going to be controlling the stabilizer, like the rudder and the elevator. So that'll be also then another activity there. It has to go there, and let's say facing down. That's how I find it has to be. And another complicated thing is going to be to connect those wires. So first steps I'll do is figure out what type of connection. Try to connect them with the same distance wire of the engine to the ESC, so there's no kind of minimize the chances of losing of energy. And then I have to try it and see if they actually work, which I'll probably then pair up the ESC with the transmitter and make sure that it works. Once that is somehow working, or at least that I can test it, then I'll make the installation. And as I say, I want to put the ESC at this height, or at this level, or let's say ahead of the fuselage, basically in the cockpit. So let's see how I manage to squeeze that in, and then do the connection up. I do feel it's a bit early to do the connection, but if I can't do it now, then or at least if it doesn't work, then I'm going to have to figure out what other motors to use. Will I go rubber? I don't think so. I don't want to. I'll have to go then to brushless motors. I need two ESCs for that and things like that. So it's going to be much more complicated, and I don't have the equipment or the experience. So that's now the next headache, which is, I'm going to say, more technological headache than structural headache. And let's see how it goes. So I'll keep you posted on this one. I'm running into problems because this is not working. So what I did, I prepared even a diagram, trying to be professional at this. This would be the battery, this is the ESC, and then I have the two motors connected in parallel. That's what I found out. And here I have the ESC with a connection to the battery. The battery is up here, and then I have the two motors. And as you see, I've already put in the cabling to connect the motors in parallel. But when I connect them, the motors turn a little bit. I managed to pair up the ESC with the transmitter. The motors turn a little bit and then they stop. I've then tried to do it with just one motor and it does the same thing. So now I'm not sure if I might have broken the ESC. So I'm a bit worried there and looking for options, getting up against a brick wall. What I'm going to try to do now, I'm going to maybe solder one motor directly and see if maybe it's the quality of the connection, or maybe there's some kind of security device in the ESC that I don't know of and there's no documentation anywhere, or maybe I have really blown it and then I have to really see what other options there are, or if I declare this project a failure. I don't know. Let's see, I'll keep you posted. So I have now soldered the cables of the motor to the ESC. I've connected the battery. I hear, I don't know if you can hear it, but I do hear the servos turning. So now I'm going to see if I can, okay, the engine is now active. Let's see if it turns and holds. Yes, that's good. That gives me some hope, because maybe it was just that the connection was too weak just by touching the contacts. So if I manage to, I'll try to solder the whole setup. I have to think how I'll do that in a way that I don't need to unsolder too often, because I'm not really good at it yet. So, but that's good. Gives me some hope. So I now have both motors connected with this flimsy setup, which I hope is correct. And I'm going to try, I've just put in the battery. We've got the transmitter here also controlling it, and now I'm going to see if it gets the energy it needs. So I hear the servos are working. Let's see about the motors. Okay, activate, and now let's see if they both turn. Yes, they both seem to be turning. You can't see them turn, but they move when they, due to the torque. So, and they go up and down. Good. So that's a bit of a relief, actually quite a big relief, because I wasn't sure what I was going to do. I already had actually plans of what to do, like contingency plans, but that's very good. So what I'm going to do now is take it apart, leave the soldered wires connected to the ESC, take the other wires apart, maybe solder some of them, and start also to prepare the installation of the engines in the engine nacelles. So that's probably going to be also the next bolts of work. It's going to be about installing here, fixing this, right? And installing here the gearboxes and the engines, and then putting the wire, if I pointed it somehow, putting the motor cables in here, through here. I'll probably have to drill some holes through here, bring the cables in here, and then at this point connect it to the cables that I've already soldered onto the ESC. And also I'll have to build up some kind of a stand for the ESC to be on. The ESC needs to be relatively high up, because it then going to control the elevator and the rudder, so it needs to be relatively high up. But it works. I'm going to try it again just for fun, because it's really good. Yeah, they both turn and they get a lot of power, so good. So next update when I have a bit more progress on it. Thank you. So finally here it is. I managed to put in the ESC, a little bit crooked, but it's there. The dashboard is actually on the wrong side, because I put it thinking it would be on the other side, but then I had to stick the ESC there, so I just turned it around so it won't be seen. But I have then the ESC connected, I've put in the battery also, there, number one, and there are the two motors, and let me do a test to see if it works. Okay, servos work, activating motors, and let's see if the motors turn. Not sure you can see it, but it moves, so that's good, so that seems to be working, and a bit of a fright with the electronics really, but successful, so I'm happy so far. Next steps, I have to see what it's going to be. But thank you for watching. Of course, just leave some comments or some recommendation. We'll be glad about that. Like it if you like it. And see you next time.